What's going on, everybody? What's going on? Make sure everybody's in here. What up, Tony? There he is. Let me get you in here, man. Here we go. Stuff up is trying to get Tony in here. Turn this down here. Yo, whenever you're ready, man. We're trying to get people on here, you know what I'm saying? I say I can try and add you.
I was trying to connect it on my iPad.
There it is, my boy.
That shit didn't work, man. Come on, iPad. Get better.
What's going on, my man?
What's up, dog? How are you?
I'm good, yo. How's this quarantine shit doing to you, man? Seriously.
Well, today I was the most active I've been in a long time. I went to the range this morning. That was phenomenal.
There you go.
Didn't have to wear a mask. That was awesome as well.
You had to wear a mask at the range?
I was 6 feet apart from everybody regardless.
Hey, I feel you. I feel you there. Social distancing at its finest. Yeah.
Pretty much. Excuse me. Then I went hiking with my boys, and that was a terrible, terrible decision. Oh, my God.
Really?
I'm exhausted.
Oh, if I say some much-needed exercise during this time, though. Yeah, I bet.
As much as I've been eating, and I literally just had, like, this smack. So I went live on my Insta, like, a little bit ago. I was at this place, Blazing Swine. It was, like, a food truck they had up at the Brester Club. That shit was amazing. I was
tuning in. You had the brisket with the mac and cheese? Oh, my God. That shit looked fucking fire. I'm not going to lie.
Different.
For real.
I'm excited to be here. I'll say that. I made it in time. Thank God. I've been running around all day.
I can see you were just live 20 minutes ago down the street, but now you're here with us. You know what I'm saying? The gazebo, like I said to Pisha, the gazebo is wherever we go. Either it's remote, it's virtual. You know what I'm saying? Like, we bring this shit with the, you know what I'm saying, personality. You know what I'm saying? It's a vibe. You know what I'm saying? Shout out to Sean.
Oh, yeah.
It's a fucking vibe.
Big facts. There's somebody in them comments that's going to get some big vibes coming here, too. We'll talk episode 9. I didn't even release 8 yet, but I know he's tuning in right now. So,
hey, we talking about, you know what I'm saying? Hey, let him know. Let him know. Shout him out, Tony. Shout him out.
Well, Harry Cap's got a big plan coming that him and I are going to
– Hey.
We can't give too many details yet, but wait till episode 9. It's going to be –
This is the place that, you know what I'm saying, you release a little bit, get a little preview, you know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? Like, yo, tell the people what's up. Yo, H-Cap, you know what I'm saying? Yo, I used to play basketball with you in middle school, bro, if you remember that shit.
Shout out, H-Cap, you know, and I used to fight on the soccer field in high school. Hey. Now he cuts my hair, so, I mean, hey.
That's my guy. Middletown shit, you know what I'm saying? We all connected here, you know what I'm saying? 717 shit, and speaking of that.
Yeah, you see that?
That's what I'm saying, bro. Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Yo, for real, bro. That's what's going on.
Yeah, man. So excited to be here.
Gazebo's
got a lot coming, so
the shed and the gazebo is, you know what I'm saying, linking up right now. That's the best part, because I know that I'm trying to get a full episode with you, and I know that you trying to get a full episode with me, you know what I'm saying? Like, we trying, you get what I'm saying? Like, we trying to get in that shit.
We got plans. Don't worry, you know that. We got plans. Plans
coming.
That's
what I'm saying. That's what I'm saying. So right now, like I said before, we go way back, bro. You and I, you know what I'm saying? Our families, a heritage, you know what I'm saying? Like, I'm just appreciate that you're on here, bro. Like, for real, for real. On some stealing shit, on some, like, personal shit. I appreciate that you actually on here right now. We got a bunch of people because of you right now.
There's a lot of cool people that joined in. My Bloomsburg people are here. I see all of them. What's good?
Yeah, shout them out.
Ilya, I don't know how you're on here because we just hiked for I don't know how long, and I'm dead, so, you know, I feel good. I feel good, though. I feel less fat, but I ate some brisket, so.
Hey.
But I made it. I'm here.
So, it's a balance. You know what I'm saying?
I feel. Yeah, I literally evened out. I told the guide when I interviewed him, I was like, yeah, you didn't help me when I just hiked, but this was a phenomenal decision of my life. So
I needed that for the food experience. Yo, and my man's about to say, yo, Peachka sent me the information. I need to hook up with my boy. Is he literally going to be in 717 for a while now? Or
no idea. He's been traveling. COVID kind of just has him going here and there. No, my aunt and her neighbor, they've been close for forever and ever. I mean, the whole family's tight. They wanted to come up with that idea because everybody in the area has been having food trucks. And I was even complaining. I'm like, where the hell is one in my hometown?
True.
And we finally got one. And that was amazing. Best brisket I've ever had.
I was tuning in, seeing what I'm saying, to the live. And as you see in all the comments, I was looking. Yo, that shit look fucking fire. For real,
fire. Fire. Yeah.
I need to check that out. I need to tune him in, you know what I'm saying? You need to check the podcast, the Tony Shed Talk for your, you know what I'm saying, for your live. Check that out. But for
that was good.
Tell me a little bit about how this quarantine has, you know what I'm saying, affected you and your creative process through the Shed Talk and through, you know what I'm saying, creating in general.
So, I mean, this is the perfect time for creators to kind of get. You know, I've been sitting in my room working for almost 2 months, and it's really let me dive into some really cool thoughts, being able to kind of work with people in the area recently to do a lot. I mean, that's been the craziest part is I've been able to have guests on my podcast through quarantine. I was thankful for everybody that's been on.
Mm-hmm. Shout out Nikki the Jet, you know what I'm saying? Shout out
Nikki the Jet.
Was Joey Julius fun?
Joe Julius was right at the beginning of that.
Gotcha.
Funny enough, Joe and I were gonna go golfing today, and he's gotta move into his apartment, but I'll be out with him hopefully next week. So
golfing's back open. Social distancing.
It's about damn time I can go out and get drunk on a course and have some fun, you know.
Yes, sir.
So
Yes, sir.
But no, man, so yeah, it's been really creative. It's been a real fun time being you know, there's a lot going on right now that we're all dealing with, kind of struggling a little bit. But at the same time, dude, everybody should be thinking, yeah, hey, Tony. But I'm also Tony. Yeah.
Shout out my man, yo.
Nah, it's been fun, man. There's a lot of things coming. You know, we're about to get out of this damn thing. I'm hoping, like,
you too,
hopefully,
bro.
Tom Wolf better make some decisions here. Or I'm gonna be a little pissed. So I'm tired of being in my house.
Straight up, yeah. I must say, like, luckily enough, I've been, you know, able to work from home. Luckily, you know what I'm saying. But that's just a lot of people haven't. A lot of people have not. You know what I'm saying, through this time.
And I feel that for people that aren't able to. It sucks. It really does. Yeah. And I wish the best for everybody right now, especially with everything going on. Like.
Mm-hmm.
It's not easy. I know my mom and my brother are home. Brother's in school. Mom's not working. But, like, me and dad are. Dad's still out on his route. I'm here. But,
yeah,
things still work, you know?
It's very – I'm about to say, like, on some real shit, it's very interesting to see, like, who's essential and who's not and who's getting paid on this – you know what I'm saying? Like, it's very interesting. People that work from home are making a lot of money right now, but people that are working actually, like, on the front lines, they're not making a lot of fucking money, and they're putting their life in line. They're putting their people, they're putting their families in line. That's really what it is, bro. Like, at the end of the day, I live with my grandparents, same as Peachka, same as, you know what I'm saying, like, a lot of people, you know what I'm saying, I live with a vulnerable people, you know what I'm saying, a vulnerable group of people,
mm-hmm. and
trying to stay safe through this is difficult, bro, seriously.
Believe me, and I have family members all over my neighborhood, like, that are old. I mean, my whole family lives in one freaking town, pretty much. So,
sure,
you see them all the time, and you gotta be safe with all this stuff. I mean, now shout out to, but do I will say, like, shout out to the essentials that are out there. Y'all are doing me a favor, and the whole world a favor by being yourselves, being your job. You know, really understanding how we need you, no matter what's going on. I have a lot of family that are nurses. I've said it a few times in my podcast that are out there grinding every day. It's a lot of work, man. Like, there's some crazy stuff going on. So shout out to my essentials. Shout out to everybody that's, you know, going through. We're all going through this. So we got to figure out how we can get out of this and continue to move forward.
Yeah. And, And our podcast, our platform right now, that's trying to do something right now. Like, I'm just trying to connect with people on a virtual level, you know what I'm saying? Remotely, whatever it is, like, get people to tell their story, get people to tell what they're going through right now. So, like I said, I know you're going through a lot of shit right now with the creative process, but tell me a little bit about how, you know what I'm saying, how the you know what I'm saying, from the beginning, for people that are not familiar, how the Shed Talk got together, you know what I'm saying, how it starts from right now, you know what I'm saying, how it got to this point.
So
a little inspiration, you know what I'm saying?
A couple beers in the shed is usually how a conversation is brought up. I will say it started off different than most people would think. There was originally going to be four of us running the show. That didn't, I mean,
who's
there was
the
a whole conversation.
Is it the four that's there now? Because there's still four technically, but.
I mean, it's not the original four. The original four was going to be myself, Nate, and my two boys. They're still doing their own things and obviously big supporters of what we do. It kind of got cut, and nothing really happened as far as, like, cuts or anything like that. Nate and I we always hung out in the shed. Like, he was working at Panera, yeah. And we would get off around the same time. I'd get home from the gym. I go to the gym every day after work. I have to, or I'm going to get fatter.
We all got
to. Right. But, no, we always sat in the shed, you know, shot the shit, just doing this. And we were joking before with the four of us saying, we should do a podcast. And I was like, Nate, like, here's the idea. We're not doing anything different than what we'd be doing on a podcast. And I think people would vibe with what we do. So, I don't know. We talked about really cool things. And then we had conversations. And a lot of people are like, yeah. I pitched the idea to just some friends, and they're like, dude, that's a cool idea. I feel like you can do it. And I was like, well, I'll try. I mean, sure. Yeah. It's been fun. So it's now we've gotten, we first released our first episode in February. Little intro, Nate and I, it was cool. We're up to seven released,
yes,
with eight coming on Monday.
On Monday.
Right now, it's crazy. Like, we have over 1,000 listeners. I am dumbfounded by that. I was like, I appreciate everybody that continues to tune in. Like, it's fun. And this next episode is going to be really fun, too. It's a cool guest. He's the owner of Burger Yum. Okay. And you'll learn a little bit more about him, more than just a businessman. He's, to give you a little hint, he was placed third place at Mr. America this past year for bodybuilding. Like, Mr. America. I didn't know that about the guy. I was like, wait, what?
Oh.
Yeah, Burger, big bodybuilder.
Yum and a Mr. America. You don't think that's connected, for real, for real?
He doesn't eat his burgers much. That's why. But his burgers are great, and you'll hear why in the episode. I can't give that secret out, but it is. You could actually find that on his website, for real, but we talked a little bit more about it in depth. So, for y'all listening in, it's a good one.
Y'all got some really great guests, you know what I'm saying, coming through. And that's sort of what I rely on in my platform, you know what I'm saying, was the people that I interview, including you, you know what I'm saying, right this second, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Really what it relies on is the people. And when it comes down to, like I said, when it comes down to picking artists or picking topics, I know you rely on a lot on feedback, dead thoughts, you know what I'm saying, on the people that are listening in. They send in their on the suggestions and the things that they're thinking about. Talk to me a little bit about how you get your content, you know what I'm saying? Like, I've been interested on how you get your fan feedback and participation, you know what I'm saying? Like, how do you, you know, how you get your content?
The content, now, if we're talking from a podcast perspective, obviously that's the team. You know, we come up with some decent ideas, get a little creative in the mind, really just like, okay, who are some people we know? What are some really cool topics to talk about? Things that are relatable to, you know, everyday life. And you think about what the podcast really means, you know, you can do it anywhere, but like, it's cool because we're sitting in a comfortable two recliners in a shed that has been a part of my family's history for a long time. When I grew up, we had one. This is a new model. It's like phenomenal. And, you know, I'm actually in the process of buying a house with a shed on it, hopefully, or at least putting one on. So,
I did
you'll get to see that too.
Glad to hear it. In the process. Oh, congratulations. Keep going.
Next
bro.
Few months. But
going. What up, Peach? What's going on?
There she is. Hey. But
hey, girl.
No, so as far as content, you know, how we come up with the ideas and people we've brought on, I mean, it's literally, you know, we said it in our one, it was in our Q&As from, or I should not even say Q&As, it was from our topic and discussion of episode 7. Okay. Really, it's about, you know, people that vibe with us. It's about people that, you know, they're doing something crazy right now. And we want to show our community is doing a lot more than you'd imagine. So it's really cool. I'm really excited for what's to come. It's really awesome that a lot of people are already tuning in. I mean, I already have, you know, 400 plus followers on the Instagram. I never thought I'd hit that feat, even just in a few months, man. Like, it seems like such a small number right now, but like, I'm really excited. I don't care, man. Like, this is cool. I don't care about all that. I care about the community that I'm a part of and mm-hmm. the people that I'm supportive with. So like, especially in these times, man, we're getting through this. So I'm glad that I'm able to still bring content to you guys.
No, seriously. I keep dropping. Yo, Tony, for real. Like, your content has been very inspirational to myself, you know what I'm saying, a lot of people, because you bring on people that have a lot of shit to say, you know what I'm saying? Even if it's just you personally, you three, you know what I'm saying, you, Nate, and Peachka, y'all are talking about real shit. It's relatable. Like I'm saying, it's trying to be content that's everyday relatable to people, and that's really what I'm trying to do, the same thing here. And that's really why I wanted to bring you on, because I know we got a lot of shit in common, you know what I'm saying? Like,
yeah.
Yeah, I remember the first time, you know what I'm saying? Like, when I told you about the podcast, you were like, yo, come through on an HMAC show. Like, come through. Yeah, like, we talked about that. They were like, yo, two podcasts out of Harrisburg. And you know what I'm saying? I know that there's two big motherfucking podcasts coming out of here, bro. Seriously.
Oh, yeah. No, and HMAC night was a good time. I mean, shit.
It was.
No, that was a cool concert. Got to see this. Got to see some of the gang.
That was one of the last concerts before coronavirus.
Yeah, same. That was a good one to see. I mean, people don't realize. I mean, Harrisburg does have a lot of talent. That entire lineup, I was very impressed with. To be real with you, I only knew a couple heads because I was close with them. Mm-hmm. But then when I started seeing, some of the people, honestly, I'm starting to more incorporate with local talent more than anything. Yeah. Seeing what's going on, like, dude, obviously we all hear our typicals. You know, I'm a big fan of Travis Scott, big fan of J. Cole and Kendrick Lamar.
Yeah, those obviously
Drake just dropped the fire mixtape. A lot of people are giving it a lot of shit, but I am a big fan. But, like, people don't see what's good around here. So people forget Harrisburg has a lot, and I'm proud of where I'm from, and it's cool to be a part of this.
Exactly, yo. That's the platform that we're trying to bring, is the 717, you know what I'm saying, the area that we've been around, the people that we've been around in this area. Like,
and grow farther.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah,
I'm not just going here. I'm going worldwide, I hope. That's hope.
That's what I'm saying. So there's a lot of people that even we've been fucking with right now that are international, seriously. Like, whether it's producer, a music video producer, anything. Like, there's a lot of people that are international right now. Even Peachka. She's fucking, you know what I'm saying, international.
Cousin and I got some big plans coming. Might take a trip across the pond.
Oh, God damn. That's big fucking news right there.
We'll see.
Wherever this leads, you know what I'm saying, this quarantine shit. Seriously.
Right. I gotta get out of quarantine first. People think it's such a halt, but go ahead.
No, tell me a little bit about your goal, your mission with Shed Talk. You know what I'm saying? When you started this, what is the mission? What you thought about? You know what I'm saying?
Well, what I thought about, you know, what inspired me to do a podcast is a Joe Rogan Experience. Huge fan of the podcast. Huge fan. Honestly, it was Joe Rogan. Oh, there he is. What's up, dog?
Fans, yo.
One of my guests. What's good, dog?
Guest of both. A rare guest of both.
That is true. Yes. Now, we were, holy shit, I just lost my train of thought. Wow, I'm terrible.
Bad. I was talking about Peachka, you know what I'm saying? Britain, and all that.
Once this all kind of wraps up, dude, well, I'm hoping to get overseas. We'll see. got some big things coming. She's got connections that I've yet to meet, and they're cool people. I met one on FaceTime. He's a good guy. So
cool. Seriously.
But
no, but yeah, she's got a lot. So tell me a little bit, like I said, the goals and the mission about the podcast right now.
The goals and missions. Well, my goal is to be like Joe Rogan. I mean, the guy's hilarious. I think him and I have a very similar personality. Just I'm a people person. And people know that about me. I'm never arrogant about stuff. Like I just like to get to know people. Like, it's so fun to, like, that's my job. I'm in a job where I work with people in IT who I'm learning about what they do, or I'm learning about how their business runs. I'm learning about how all this kind of works together and putting the pieces together. And it's cool that I'm able to kind of be that. Like, it's the glue that sticks it together. Right. Like, I'm learning about how business operates on different industries. I'm learning how, because technology's the next thing going on, you know? So it's already going on, but like continuing, like, so that's where it inspired me. Like, I know I'm a people person. I do that kind of job, and being on a podcast is just fun. It's something that I do on a regular basis, regardless if I'm on a camera or not. Like, it's fun. It's just enjoyable. But the goals are to get, you know, once I have my own place, once I have everything kind of wrapped up, because, you know, college puts you in a shit ton of debt. Thank you a lot, Bloomsbury University. You did me
we both done graduated though. Seriously, we both
done and graduated. I'm happy about it, but $100,000 piece of paper. It ain't like that, but anywho, it's worth it. It's very worth it.
That's a different conversation.
Right.
That's a shed thought in itself, right there.
As a big shed thought, I'm hoping, you know, to see what happens with my own project. But that's the whole goal of the project. I'm just going to sum it up here: is I want this to be my day to day. Is just continue. This is my product. This is our product as a company. You know, it's not a company, but it's a podcast, and I think business minded. So, like, if I can get this thing rolling and be my own boss with my two partners and others that are getting involved, like, we're just going to continue grinding, continue moving, and let's just see what happens.
That's the same place I'm at, bro. I'm in the very beginning stages of what I'm doing. You know what I'm saying? And I take a lot of inspiration from you guys. I'm not serious.
Appreciate that, man.
I listen to every single episode. I've been tuned in. Like, I love podcasts. I'm that type of person that listens to people. You know what I'm saying? And you, the type of people that you have on, that I have on, they have a story to tell. And a lot of local artists, local people that create. I don't want to limit myself to just musical artists, and I know that you don't as well. You have a lot of people that come on that are beyond music, and the shit that we do right here on Live from the Gazebo, that's supposed to be a community of people that are very innovative, creative on any type of platform that you have, whether it's a nonprofit business that you own, whether you're a content creator of any kind. Seriously, I want you to have the platform to have your art performed, or, you know what I'm saying, like, platformed, or, you know what I'm saying, or something that the people can respect and understand, for real.
And it's cool because, like, I can also use my platform as a voice. Like, people don't voice their concerns and opinions enough, and it's another platform. That's how I get people involved with my shed thoughts, is, like, people chime in and give us ideas, and we're like, oh, it's really cool, like, mm-hmm. Again, like, I had a phone call 2 days ago with Harry, and mm-hmm. I'm very excited. Like, it's I've been talking about it a lot recently with some internal people. Like, I'm gonna say it's my mother, because that's my best friend in the same breath. To be fair, but it's really fun. It's we'll see what happens, but.
No, seriously. And I appreciate you, you know what I'm saying, taking the time tonight to, you know what I'm saying, talk to us a little bit about what you've been doing. This is just a little preview of what's to come, because I know that I need you on a full episode of the Gazebo, and same here. I'm trying to be on Shed Talk for real.
We got plans. Just wait. We got season 2 coming. Like, this is all just intro right now. We haven't even finished season 1. Season 2 will be different. I'll leave it where it's at, but I'm telling you, man, Me and the team have been cooking, and I'm really excited about it. A lot of people are getting involved. And I know you will be as well. So it will be, we'll be in touch about that specifically.
Yes, sir, Anthony. Like I said before, bro, you, me and you, we're connected on a different type of level, bro. Seriously.
For sure, dude.
Yeah. And I appreciate your time. Tell the people right now, everybody that's tuning in, let me shout them out. You know what I'm saying? Let me check those. Everybody's in here. Shout out, you know what I'm saying? Weston, my dad, you know what I'm saying? I'm not sure.
Yeah, there are a lot of people in and out. But hey, but a lot tell of cool people
right now. Everybody's going to tune in because I'm going to post this, you know what I'm saying? I'm going to post this on. Tell the people what they need to know about you and about Shed Talk and anything that they need to know.
What you got to know is you got to follow us to find out more. You got to continue to, you know, I release a lot of stuff. I shout out to my team guys. Nate, you're the best partner I could have had, as well as Nikki, you know, being my family, being one of my favorite cousins. You know, it's her and I have been close for years.
She's the best.
She's awesome. Like she's helped me so much.
Shout out Nikki.
I'm here because of my team forever. And, you know, you can find us at Shed Talk Podcast on Instagram as well as on Twitter. So find us. We'll post our Shed Thoughts. And, hey, I see everybody on episode 8 on Monday morning. Make sure you guys are tuning in on the Shed Talk.
There it is. Y'all heard it here first, hopefully. Heard it here.
I didn't post anything about it yet. I've hit it. Actually, I tweeted once. I tweeted one time, and it's going to be different. You'll see. But this is where the real announcement is. So
exactly.
Episode 8 coming on Monday, and you'll see what happens after that and until we shed again.
There we go. I love it. I love it, Tony. Yo, thank you for tuning in. This is the place where fucking exclusive shit happens. So thank you.
Absolutely, man.
Yeah. And like my man Wes, yo. Tune in to my man Weston, yo. Tony, if you haven't, yes. He's trying to get on Shed Talk too.
Tune in. I see that. I'll have to give him a shout. Shoot me a follow, man. We'll have to talk.
There we go. I love the collaboration. I love that people can connect through this. Tony, I appreciate your time. Thank you so much. Hey,
thank you for yours. Appreciate it.
This is just a little preview, man. Have a good night, all right? Stay safe.
You too, right? Brother.
All right, man. I love you, bro. Take care.
Loves always. See ya.
Thank you, everybody that's tuning in right now. You know what I'm saying? Let me shout you out. You know what I'm saying? Shout out my dad. Shout out Wes. Shout out Tony. Yo, thank you guys so much. Wes, I'm going to cop that shit. I'm telling you, I got paid. I'm trying to cop that. You know what I'm saying? I'm just deciding between the sweatshirt or the, you know what I'm saying, the hoodie or the t-shirt. Like, honestly, like, y'all got a bunch of different options. Wes, if you're still in here. All right. Either way. I'm trying to cop. Born for Perspective, Shed Talk, live from the gazebo. I love y'all. Good night.